بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. We continue the explanation of the four rules. And the author رحمه الله mentions the first rule by saying أن تعلم أن الكفار الذين قاتلهم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم مقرون بأن الله تعالى هو الخالق الرازق المدبر وأن ذلك لم يدخلهم في الإسلام. والدليل قوله تعالى قل من يرزقكم من السماء والأرض أم من يملك السمع والأبصار ومن يخرج الحي من الميت ويخرج الميت من الحي ومن يدبر الأمر فسيقولون الله فقل أفلا تتقون. The first rule, which the author mentioned, translates to the following. The first rule is to know that the disbelievers whom the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fought acknowledged and attested that Allah is the sole creator and that He is the provider and the one in whose hand is the disposal of all affairs. Yet the disbelievers were not considered Muslims. This did not make them Muslims. Listen carefully to this. This did not make them Muslims. Meaning that their sheer acknowledgement of the Lordship of Allah was not enough or sufficient to qualify them to be Muslims. Because they did not actually dedicate the acts of worship or all the acts of worship to Allah alone. They did not submit to Allah alone in worship. And the author gave the evidence for this in Surah Yunus, chapter 10, verse 31, relating the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, قُلْ مَنْ يَرْزُقُكُمْ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ أَمَّنْ يَمْلِكُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَمَنْ يُخْرِجُ الْحَيَّ مِنَ الْمَيِّتِ وَيُخْرِجُ الْمَيِّتَ مِنَ الْحَيِّ وَمَنْ يُدَبِّرُ الْأَمْرَ فَسَيَقُولُونَ اللَّهِ فَقُلْ أَفَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. Say, O Muhammad, صلى الله عليه وسلم, who provides for you from the sky and from the earth? Or who owns hearing and sight? And who brings out the living from the dead and brings out the dead from the living? And who disposes the affairs? You see, their response will be, look at this. They will say, Allah. They acknowledge this. Say, will you not then be afraid of Allah's punishment for setting up rivals in worship with Allah? No. So, this is the first rule which the author, rahimahullah, mentioned. That to know that those mushriks, those disbelievers, whom the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fought and the companions fought, they attested to singling Allah alone in lordship. That Allah is their creator, their sustainer, their provider, the one who runs the affairs, all of their affairs. They didn't have a doubt about this. However, the ignorant of the Muslims nowadays, think that this tawheed is sufficient, is enough. They think that this belief in the lordship of Allah is enough. And this is from ignorance. Why? Because the mushriks are more knowledgeable than them. And the mushriks, they said that Allah, if you ask them who is your Lord, they will say our Lord is Allah, He created us, He is the one who provides for us. They attested to that, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about them in Surah Al-Zukhruf 43:87, ولئن سألتهم من خلقهم ليقولن الله. And if you ask them who created them, they will surely say Allah. And also regarding the creation of the universe, Allah tells us also that they attested to that in Surah Al-Ankabut 29:61. وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ وَسَخَّرَ الشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ. And if you were to ask them, who created the heavens and the earth and subjected the sun and the moon? They will say, surely, they will reply, Allah. How then are they deviating as polytheists and disbelievers? So the mushriks, the disbelievers, the polytheists attested and acknowledged this. And as to their provisions, even they admitted to this, as in Surah Yunus 10:31, which we related earlier, which the author also used as an evidence. So if you know that, then why don't you fear Allah and stop ascribing partners to Him in worship, and you return to the true Tawheed and to the truth? So they knew these things and they attested to that, yet they did not, this of course did not benefit them. Rather, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam fought them because they did not single Allah alone in worship. They set partners with Him in worship, worshipping Al-Lat, one of their idols, the Uzza and Manat, and their idols were many. And now therefore from this we know that the Tawheed, the true Tawheed, is to have all worship to Allah alone and to believe that He alone deserves to be worshipped, none besides Him or to the exclusion of Him. And therefore from this we know another benefit, that the Tawheed is not only the attestation of lordship, and that shirk is not only in the shirk of rububiyya, of lordship. In fact, if you, when compared to the people of on the earth, you will find few who ascribe partners to Allah in His lordship. All the nations attest to the lordship of Allah, that He is the creator, sustainer, the one who brings life, causes death, the one who runs the affairs. Meaning they attest to single Allah alone in His actions. In His actions. No one claims that there are other creators with Allah, or other sustainers besides Allah, or those who, or there is other than Allah who gives life and takes it. The mushriks, the disbelievers, knew these things, that Allah is the creator, sustainer, provider, etc. So the Tawheed therefore is not the sheer attestation to this lordship, as it is stated by some scholastic theologians in their creeds. They attest that the Tawheed is to single Allah alone as the creator, sustainer, provider, the one who brings death, causes death and gives life, brings the dead from the living, brings out the living from the dead, and they tell you that the Tawheed is, quote, that Allah is one in His essence, indivisible, one in his attributes, no resemblance, one in his actions, no partner to him in his actions. This is, in fact, if you look at it, this is what Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. This is the Tawheed of Lordship, singling Allah as the Lord. If you go and examine the books written by the scholastic theologians, you will find them not diverging from this definition of Tawheed. But this is not the Tawheed which the messengers proclaimed. And conveyed and called for. Attesting to this Tawheed of Lordship is not a benefit to the individual. We knew now that the mushriks and their leaders, they acknowledged that. And this did not take them out from disbelief. This did not take them out from disbelief. And did not make them enter the fold of Islam. So therefore this is a great mistake that Tawheed is the Tawheed of Lordship. Anyone who still believes in that, then he is still on the same creed of Abu Jahl and the same creed of Abu Lahab. Leaders from the disbelievers at the time of the Prophet ﷺ. And so, some of the so-called educated in our times, they attest to this type of Tawheed and they say that this is the Tawheed. But they don't mention the most important aspect of the Tawheed in terms of the worship, and that is to single Allah alone in worship, having all worship sincere for Allah. And in fact this is necessitated if people contemplate carefully about it. If you attest to the Tawheed of Lordship, then this necessitates that you single Allah alone in worship. So therefore, to make the Tawheed center upon the aspect of Lordship, this is a grave mistake. Now what is shirk to them? What is shirk to them? The shirk, they say, we talk the scholastic theologians, they say is أن تعتقد that you believe أن أحدا يخلق مع الله أو يرزق مع الله. That you believe that there is others besides Allah who create or who provide sustenance. And this is not said by Abu Lahab. This is not said by Abu Jahl. None of them, none of the mushriks and their leaders said that there is a creator besides Allah and that there is a sustainer besides Allah. They acknowledged that Allah is the creator and the sustainer and the one who gives life and the one who causes death. Now, this is the first rule, and the second rule, which the author rahimahullah mentioned, Al-Qa'ida al-Thaniya. The second rule, أنهم يقولون ما دعوناهم وتوجهنا إليهم إلا لطلب القربة والشفاعة. فدليل القربة قوله تعالى والذين اتخذوا من دونه أولياء ما نعبدهم إلا ليقربونا إلى الله زلفى إن الله يحكم بينهم فيما هم فيه يختلفون إن الله لا يهدي من هو كاذب كفار. The second rule is that the mushriks, the polytheists, say we didn't call on them, meaning the idols, and we didn't approach them except to seek nearness, intercession, and intercession through them, meaning to seek nearness of Allah and to draw nearer to Allah and to intercede through them. And the proof that they take or rather with the evidence with respect to drawing near to Allah, which is called Al-Qurba in Arabic, and their excuse is stated in Surah Az-Zumar 39:3. So the evidence for the Qurba, seeking nearness of Allah. والذين اتخذوا من دونه أولياء ما نعبدهم إلا ليقربونا إلى الله زلفى إن الله يحكم بينهم فيما هم فيه يختلفون إن الله لا يهدي من هو كاذب كفار. Surely the religion is and those who take supporters, helpers besides Allah, say we worship them only that they may bring us near to Allah. You see that? Verily Allah will judge between them concerning that wherein they differ. Concerning that wherein they differ. And truly Allah guides not him who is a liar and a disbeliever. And with respect to the evidence concerning intercession and what they said as an excuse is in Surah Yunus 10:18. The dalil for the shafa'a is the saying of Allah, وَيَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَضُرُّهُمْ وَلَا يَنْفَعُهُمْ وَيَقُولُونَ هَؤُلَاءِ شُفَعَاؤُنَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. And they worship besides Allah things that hurt them not, nor profit them, and they say these are our intercessors with Allah, these are our intercessors with Allah. And then the author said فَالشَّفَاعَةُ وَالشَّفَاعَةُ شَفَاعَتَانِ, and the intercession is of two kinds, is of two kinds. شَفَاعَةٌ مَنْفِيَّةٌ وَشَفَاعَةٌ مُثْبَتَةٌ, an annulled intercession and a confirmed intercession. Annulled intercession and confirmed intercession. The annulled intercession, ما كانت تطلب, the author is giving the definition of the annulled intercession, ما كانت تطلب من غير الله فيما لا يقدر عليه إلا الله. And then he said that it is the one which is sought from other than Allah for needs that only Allah can fulfill. For needs that only Allah can fulfill. This type of intercession is annulled, annulled, futile. The proof is in the words of Allah, والدليل قوله تعالى in Surah Al-Baqarah 2:254. يا أيها الذين آمنوا أنفقوا مما رزقناكم من قبل أن يأتي يوم لا بيع فيه ولا خلة ولا شفاعة والكافرون هم الظالمون. O who you believe, spend of that which we have provided for you before a day comes when there will be no bargaining, no friendship, nor intercession. And it is the disbelievers who are the wrongdoers. Then he gave the definition of the الشَّفَاعَةُ الْمُثْبَتَةُ, the affirmed شفاعه, the affirmed intercession, and said, هي التي تطلب من الله والشافع مكرم بالشفاعة والمشفوع له من رضي الله قوله وعمله بعد الإذن. And the confirmed intercession is that which is sought from Allah. Sought from Allah. وَالشَّافِعُ مُكَرَّمٌ بِالشَّفَاعَةِ. And the intercessor of whom Allah approves of is the one who is honored by the privilege to interceding, while the one who is interceded for is he whose utterances and actions are pleasing to Allah. So the confirmed intercession is, it must be therefore, as you see, conditional, is that which is sought from Allah. Now the intercessor of whom Allah approves, therefore they must be approving of, is the one who is honored by the privilege to interceding, while the one who is interceded for is he whose utterances and actions are pleasing to Allah. As Allah stated in Surah Al-Baqarah, the next verse, مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَشْفَعُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ. مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَشْفَعُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ. Who is he that can intercede with him except with his permission? This is the second rule. This is the second rule. So, the disbelievers and the mushriks, you know, they said concerning the worshipping which they directed to other than Allah, they said, we didn't intend that they are our creators, their objects of worship. We didn't intend that they are our creators. We knew that Allah is the creator. And we didn't intend that they give us sustenance. We knew that Allah is the one who gives us sustenance. We didn't intend that they are the ones who run the affairs. We know that Allah is the one who runs the affairs. Nor did we intend that they are the ones who give life and take it. That is all to Allah. We know that. However, also we know that they don't benefit, nor do they harm, as Allah stated about that. But they took them as to intercede. Intercessors, intermediates. In order to attain their needs. So they offer sacrifices to them, make vows to them, not because they are, they create or sustain or etc., etc. Rather, that they are intermediates, intercessors with Allah, intercede. This is the creed of the mushriks. Why? Because they said they are better than us. They are awliya, they are they have their status with Allah. These awliya, they call them these saints and so forth, because of their status, they are better than us. They are more, they are better in the deen than us. And they have righteous deeds and they are obedient to Allah. That's why we worship them and we invoke them besides Allah. And we ask them for help and aid. In order what? To draw us nearer to Allah and to intercede for us. You see, that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا in Surah Al-Zumar, which the author cited, 39:3, وَالَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ ما نعبدهم إلا ليقربونا إلى الله زلفى. يا ما نعبدهم. We worship them only that they bring us nearer to Allah. You see? So they didn't worship the prophets, nor did they worship the righteous, except to draw them nearer to Allah. What did Allah respond to them? I want you to contemplate this very carefully. At the end of this verse, see what Allah said. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَحْكُمُ بَيْنَهُمْ فِيمَا هُمْ فِيهِ يَخْتَلِفُونَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِي مَنْ هُوَ كَاذِبٌ كَفَّرٌ. Truly Allah guides, not verily Allah will judge between them according that wherein they differ. Now listen, truly Allah guides not him who is what? Who is what? You tell me. Huh? Truly Allah guides not who is a liar and a disbeliever. So Allah called them what? Allah called them what therefore? Liars and what? Liars and disbelievers. Liars and disbelievers. So therefore, this worship which they invented in order to seek nearness to Allah and to intercede, this is kufr, this is disbelief, and riddah, apostasy. Even though they didn't say they create them, you know, they didn't say they believe that they are not creators, they don't believe that they are not, you know, sustainers, providers, etc. They give all of that to Allah, isn't it? So therefore, if they invoke them besides Allah, seek them and seek their help, and vow, giving vow and slaughter to them in order to draw nearer to Allah and to intercede, to take them as intermediates with Allah, then this is disbelief, which is the same disbelief which the mushriks, the first mushriks, also did. And that's why Allah named them, called them liars and disbelievers. Because they lied when they said that they bring us nearer to Allah, these objects of worship, or these righteous, or these prophets, or etc. And they disbelieved by this action. While they themselves attest that they harm them not, benefit them not, as in Yunus 10:18. وَيَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَضُرُّهُمْ. Listen, he said in the beginning what? وَيَعْبُدُونَ. وَيَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَضُرُّهُمْ وَلَا يَنْفَعُهُمْ وَيَقُولُونَ هَؤُلَاءِ شُفَعَاؤُنَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. And they worship, listen, underline this, or contemplate it rather carefully. And they worship besides. وَإِيَّاكُمْ. And they worship besides Allah things that hurt them not, nor profit them. You see, they acknowledge that, right? They acknowledge that they don't harm them. They cause them no harm. You see that? you understand the point, please? They know that, they acknowledge this. But they say what? These are our intercessors with Allah because of their rank, they are better than us, they are prophets, they are awliya, they are saints, they are, quote, friends of Allah, you name it, right? So they attest that these objects of worship, they benefit them not, nor do they harm them, and that they take them as intercessors. But Allah says in Surah Al-Muddathir, verse 48.
فَمَا تَنْفَعُهُمْ شَفَاعَةُ الشَّافِعِينَ فَمَا تَنْفَعُهُمْ شَفَاعَةُ الشَّافِعِينَ
So, no intercession of intercessors will be of any use to them. Allahu Akbar. No intercession of intercessors will be of any use to them. Alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. You see that? So no intercession of intercessors will be of any use to them. Why? Because this shirk which they committed by taking these as so means of nearness and intercessors, this nullified the intercession to them. And what really benefits them truly is at-tawbah, sincere repentance to Allah, and to be upright on tawheed, worshipping, having all worship sincerely done for Allah. And this is the meaning of La ilaha illallah. There is no true God worthy of worship except Allah. You see, I don't, you know when the Muslim says this, if the Muslim does not contemplate this meaning of La ilaha illallah carefully and understands it properly, then he is vulnerable to the misconceptions of these mushriks. You understand the point? No. And if you discuss now any grave worshipper, those who call upon the dead and the graves and the grave occupants, don't they say the same thing as the early mushriks? We take them as intercessors. They say the same thing. Exactly the same thing. But when you come to discuss with him, he says, I know that this so-called saint or this righteous man does not benefit, nor does he cause harm, but he is a righteous man, and I seek intercession through him with Allah. Isn't it this what you hear? Don't you hear that from them? It's exactly the same thing. If you discuss this with any quburi meaning grave, worshipper of grave occupants. Qabr is grave. Quburi meaning the one who invokes or calls upon the occupants of the graves. So, while the believer knows the meaning of La ilaha illallah, so they single Allah alone with worship and with dua, invocation, with fear and hope. They sacrifice for Allah's sake, they make vows for Allah's sake, and they don't ascribe partners to Allah, neither a sent messenger or an angel, close angel, nor a jinni, nothing. This is and this is and this is the deen of Allah. This is Islam. This is pure Islam. So therefore the tawheed and the deen and Islam is directing all worship to Allah alone and not to be directed in any way or any form or any means to other than Allah. Even though the person may claim that this object other than Allah does not create, nor does he provide, etc. And therefore anyone who directs any of the worship to these objects besides Allah, then he commits kufr, disbelief. Even though he may state, I believe that this object does not create, is not the creator, is not the provider, is not the sustainer. That is because the mushriks had the same creed. And they knew that Allah is the creator, the provider, the sustainer. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not give them excuse in that. Rather, he mentioned and stated and ruled that they are liars and disbelievers when they sought means of nearness by other than Allah, by means of nearness through other than Allah, and intercession also in these objects of worship. So this which put them into shirk. So therefore the one who worships Badawi or Abd al-Qadir al-Jilani or the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam or an idol or a jinni and believes that they or any one of them draws them nearer to Allah, yet at the same time believing that they are not creators, then it is a duty bound upon the believer to make it clear to them that this is the major shirk and that this is the deen of the mushriks upon which they were. As Allah stated in Surah Az-Zumar 39:3, which the author cited, مَا نَعْبُدُهُمْ, we worship them not, إِلَّا لِيُقَرِّبُونَا إِلَى اللَّهِ زُلْفَى, except that they only throw us nearer to Allah, bring us nearer to Allah. So therefore it is a duty upon us to be aware and be careful concerning the misconceptions of the mushriks. Now, concerning the intercession, which the author rahimahullah classified into two types. Intercession that is confirmed and that is true has conditions to it. The first condition is that it is to be by the leave of Allah, permitted by Allah, and that the one who is interceded for is from the people of Tawheed, meaning disobedient Muslim. A Muslim who has sins. Is that clear? And that the one whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala As Allah stated in the وَلَا يَشْفَعُونَ إِلَّا لِمَنْ ارْتَضَى in Surah Al-Anbiya 21:28. So Allah approves of the one who is honored by the privilege to interceding. And so also, as Allah stated in this verse, وَلَا يَشْفَعُونَ إِلَّا لِمَنِ ارْتَضَى And they cannot intercede except for him with whom he is pleased. So all of this is included under the affirmed intercession. So therefore, excluded are the kafirs and the mushriks. The intercession of the intercessors does not avail them. And Allah stated this also in Surah Ghafir, verse 18. ما للظالمين من حميم ولا شفيع يطاع. There will be no friend nor an intercessor for the polytheists. Who could be given heed to. And no one can intercede except by the approval of Allah. And the best of creation and the final and end of the messengers, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he is to intercede with Allah on the day of resurrection, he will prostrate before the hands of Allah azza wa jal and invoke Allah and praise him with all the magnificent praises, and he continues to be in prostration until it will be said to him, irfa ra'sak, raise your head, meaning O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Raise your head and say waqul tusma, you will be listened to. وَشْفَعْ تُشَفَّعْ intercede and your intercession will be accepted. So therefore there is no intercession except when there is approval. And that the affirmed intercession is for the believers, the people of Tawheed, sinners from them. The mushrik, it doesn't help him. And the one who offers the offerings to the graves and makes the vow to the graves, this is a mushrik. He will not benefit. This concludes the second rule, and inshallah ta'ala tomorrow we continue with the third rule. والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.